In the 1930s, when I was 4 years old and my brother Bailey 5, my parents decided to put an end to their calamitous marriage. And we were shipped off to my paternal grandmother in a dusty town called Stamps, Arkansas. I suppose my parents couldn't handle us. We were too young to think much about this, and as we grew up, too busy to think much about them. So in our minds, they simply ceased to exist. There is a much-loved region in the American fantasy where pale white women float eternally under black magnolia trees, and white men with soft hands brush wisps of wisteria from the creamy shoulders of their lady loves. Harmonious black music drifts like perfume through this precious air, and nothing of a threatening nature intrudes. It's called the Deep South, and it's where I grew up.
I thank whatever gods may be for my.
What's the matter with you? Wasn't you listening? We read that part already. Next line. Next line. Dumbbell, sit down. Next.
I can't read.
You can't read? Why can't you read?
Because I don't have a book.
What? Why don't you have a book?
Because I left it home.
Oh, you did. Well, you just have to stay right here in this classroom after school till you learn that poem by heart.
Then I might as well go home. Because I already know it.
You being smart?
No, ma'am.
And don't answer me back.
Yes, ma'am. I mean, no, ma'am. I won't, ma'am. I won't answer you. Ma'am.
All right, mister. You recite that poem. And I warn you, every word better be right, or you will suffer the consequences. Come up here.
Your brother Bailey's gonna get it now. If my brother says he knows it by heart, then he knows it by heart.
Out of the night that covers me, black as the pit from pole to pole, I thank whatever gods may be for my unconquerable soul. In the fell clutch of circumstance, I have not winced nor cried aloud.
My brother Bailey was the most wonderful person in my world. He was smart and beautiful. Where I was big, elbowy, and grating, he was small, graceful, and smooth. And yet he loved me.
It matters not how straight the gate, how charged with punishment the scroll. I am the master of my fate. I am the captain of my soul.
there's milk and cornbread for you. Then come help us out.
How much flour do you want, Miss Fletcher?
Oh, I'll just take half a pound a day. No use getting extra.
I'll get it.
Don't forget your soda, Sister Fletcher. You forgot to get soda last month.
How's your baking powder?
Well, now, Sister Johnson, no use for baking powder. Nobody left that home anymore. They are all gone now.
You take this, and you bake something, and you bring it back here for my grandchildren. They'll give your bacon its due.
Especially if it's got chocolate in it.
That's mighty nice of you.
Half pound, Mrs. Fletcher?
Margaret, now you keep your eyes on that scale now. I don't need but just a half pound.
Half pound, exactly.
Maya, what's 7 times 8?
56. What's 9 times 6?
54. 11 times 11.
121. Do the 7 times table.
7, 14, 28. 7, 14, 21, 28, 35. Ow! Hurt, Uncle Willie.
Stop showing off and get the work done. We've got other things to do besides wasting their time listening to you strutting and cream.
I wasn't strutting and...
Don't talk back to your elders, Bailey Jr.
But, Mama, Bailey and me was just practicing our schoolwork.
Pride is a sin. A good book says that pride goeth before the fall. Truth be, grandchildren got more brains in their little heads than most of the big people in this whole town. Tastes good.
Mama, I don't think there's anything in this world that makes me happier than eating pineapple.
Mama, for our reading tonight.
Hey.
He's a black poet.
Hush.
Stay there, Mama. I'll look.
Annie, you in there?
Mama, it's Mr. Peters.
Children, stay back here with your Uncle Willie.
Anywhere, Willie?
Where? Why, he always be working in the store.
Tell Willie he better lay low tonight. A crazy nigger messed with a white lady. They stay from close around here. Some of the boys will be driving over this way tonight. I just drove over to warn you. No need to thank me.
Maya? Bailey Jr.? Both of you. Quick! The potatoes, the onions.
This shouldn't be. It just shouldn't be.
Mama.
Morning, Uncle Willie.
Morning. Today, little sister, I'm seeing today.
That's right, pretty sister.
You really think so, Mama?
Say so if I didn't.
What's the matter? What are you looking at? Am I getting bumps?
Not yet, sister. You and Bailey Jr. surely is growing. Surely is. Go inside, sister.
No, Mama. I want to stay with you. We'll order them off our land.
Go inside.
Watch me.
Bye, Miss Ruth. Bye, Mrs. Noyce.
Mama, you call them Miss, and you let them call you Annie. How could you, Mama? How could you? They're children. They're poor white trash. You own the land they live on, Mama. How could you let them speak that way to you? That will never happen to me. I would never allow myself to be degraded like that. I would tell them to go to hell. I would spit in their faces.
Think those crazy people won't kill you? You think those lunatic cracker boys won't try to catch you in the road and violate you? You think because you know poems and the times table, some of those men won't feel like putting on white sheets and riding over here? You do? You're wrong. There ain't nothing to protect you and us, except the good Lord and a few fake words and a few fake smiles we put on our mouths. So you'd better start learning them words and start putting that smile on your mouth.
Never.
Well, that's your choice.
My name is Rose Flowers. Rose T. Flowers. Can anyone guess what the T stands for? It stands for tulip. Rose Tulip Flowers. Don't you think that with a name like that, I should have been a gardener? Or a florist? But I preferred teaching. Why do I prefer teaching? Because I like classrooms. I like chalk. I like blackboards. I like children. I like books, and I want to share them with you. I'm going to tell you a lot of things. And one of the things I hope you will learn is that stamps is just one place in Arkansas. And Arkansas is one place in the United States. And the United States is one place in the North American continent. And the North American continent is just one place in the world. Marguerite, would you come here a minute, please?
I'll meet you out front.
Sit down. Did you write this? Uh-huh.
Yes, ma'am.
It's a lovely poem.
Thank you.
Do you like to write poems?
Yes. My brother and me. My brother's Billy Johnson. We have readings that suffer for my grandmother and my uncle. We're supposed to pick things to read. Well, anyway, Bill and me started to write our things to read. So I said I'll write some. And that's what I did.
You have a precious talent, Marguerite. Don't compromise it. Don't compromise yourself. You are what you are, and what you are is damn good.
Yeah. I really shouldn't be feeding pigs. I have a precious talent. I hate to look at those pigs. Big, fat, ugly, smelly things.
Don't let them hear you. You'll hurt their feelings.
You are so ugly, Mr. Pig. So very ugly.
But they taste good.
Yeah.
You really ought to learn to eat those pigs' tails and snouts, Mike. Yum, yum.
Billy, you trying to make me throw up?
It's part of your heritage.
Not mine.
Oh, no. What's yours, then?
Billy, you don't hear me talking with a southern accent, do you?
No, Mike.
And you don't hear me picking up any of that common slang, do you? You know why?
Why, Maya?
Because you see, Billy, I am really white.
Do tell.
The fact is, my real natural parents were white, but they died and left me in the hands of a wicked fairy godmother who was understandably jealous of my beauty and turned me into a Negro girl. Someday, Billy, someday, I'm going to wake up from this ugly black nightmare I'm in. And you see this kinky mess Mama won't let me straighten? It's all gonna disappear, and my real hair will take its place. Long and blonde and thin and silky.
And Mai, when are you gonna go out of that dumb thing?
Come on in here, you two. Here's your Christmas present.
Christmas presents? Uncle Willie, you went out and got us Christmas presents?
Never said I got them. They is from your mommy and your daddy.
Mommy and daddy?
What mommy and daddy?
Your mama Vivian and your daddy Bailey Sr. The only mommy and daddy you got.
But Uncle Willie, I thought our parents were dead.
Dead? Whoever told you that? Hey, this is for you.
handle the sister from your mommy in St. Louis.
No. No one ever said anything about our mommy.
Where you ever hear you two is orphans? We tell you that?
You're making a joke, aren't you?
These presents are really from you and Mama, right?
No, it ain't right. Be right there.
This is for you, Margaret, from your daddy, and this is for you from your mommy. These two is for you, Bailey, from your daddy and your mommy. Open them or don't.
Children is the most ungrateful things I ever did see. You think Big Bailey and Vivian went to all that trouble to buy you them nice play pretties just to make you cry?
How come they never wrote? How come they never came to see us?
Why did they send us away? What did we do that was so wrong that made them send us away?
They coming to see you. Your daddy will be here real soon.
What? My daddy? Here?
Now what you carrying on about, sister?
I don't know. I don't know. I'm just afraid.
There's nothing to be afraid for. They're your mommy and your daddy. And they love you. And you know who else loves you, too?
Who?
The Lord above. The good Lord always loves you.
You see any signs of resemblance? What are you squinting for?
Well, I do see some resemblance around the mouth and the nose and the eyes.
Well, that's just about everything, isn't it? I mean, after the eyes, nose, and mouth, what's left?
What about me? Well?
I don't know. You probably look more like Mother.
You don't even know what our mother looks like.
Well, you don't look like him.
Where you going?
I'll be home soon. I'm just going for a walk with Lorraine.
Where?
Just no place. I'll see you home.
It's gonna be dark soon.
It's okay, I tell you. I'll be home soon.
I'll go with you.
Hey, Maya, if you don't feel like taking a walk with us, you don't have to. Know what I mean?
Sister, where Billy Jr. say he going?
No place really, Mama. Going for a walk with Lorraine.
Is your daddy due to drive up to this door any minute now? What'll I tell him?
I'll go out and look for him.
Not you. Not you. Sister and me, we going. Be safer that way.
Okay. Maybe you better go then.
Sister, get your sweater and bring me my coat.
I'm sure he's all right, Mama. Nothing can happen to Bailey.
What's up with that girl?
He's all right, Mom. I know he is. He's fine.
Okay, pull him on out on the bank. Come on, move him now.
Sheriff, he sure stinks.
You'd stink too if you'd been in that pond all night.
No, sir, Sheriff, he's worse than that. He's dead, he's good and dead. I mean, he's rotten dead.
Turn him over.
Who is it, Jim? You can't hardly tell what his face looks like anymore.
Anybody know this man?
He was probably new in town.
Turn that sheet all the way down.
Please, boss, I don't want to touch him.
He ain't gonna hurt you, he's too dead. Give me that stick. Get back, son. I want to turn this sheet down where I can see his shoes. That way I can tell whether he's from the farm or the city.
Sweet honor. Who would do that?
Son, I told you.
Sheriff, look at his shoes. He's a city fella, all right.
Junior, you know it's night and you just now getting home. What you been doing? Bailey Junior, what's got into you? Something scared you?
What is it, Bail?
Leave me alone.
I saw him. He was dead. They killed him and they wrapped him in the sheet and put him at the bottom of the pond. Dead now.
What did he look like, Bill? What did he look like?
He was bloated like a ball. He had no color. No color. His eyes were wide open. And they cut him. They cut him.
What?
Oh, Maya.
Why'd they do it, Bill? Why'd they kill him?
I don't know. They hate us, that's all. They just hate us.
But why?
I don't know. Oh, Maya, I hope our daddy comes soon.
Who is that?
Bailey?
Your daddy!
My goodness.
Now, who are those two good-looking children there?
Mama, in all of California, no, in all of the world, don't nobody make sweet potato pie like this.
Well, I made it just for you.
Is it still your favorite?
Still my favorite.
Yeah.
Babe. I'm sorry. Lord, look like Dad's little girl's trying to fly away there.
Why don't you go picking on sister? She's a good girl.
Picking on her? Mama, I just love sitting here looking at her. Dad's little man there? Won't anybody ever tell you you look just like me?
Uh-uh, Daddy. Nobody knew what you look like.
Well, I guess he got one on me that time.
How you doing in California, Billy?
I'm doing real fine, Willie. That California is a real beautiful state. People treat you real good, too. Not like here where you got to run around with your head tucked between your legs.
Ooh. You making ends meet, honey.
Am I making ends meet? Mama, I am making ends meet and then some. You seen that car out there? That's a LaSalle. 18 more months and it's mine completely. These clothes. These expensive clothes here. And this here gold watch. You know how much that costs?
Well, what's... Big Billy, I hope there's more to life than a price tag. You been attending church?
Well, Mama's still religious as ever, huh?
Yes, sure she is. Means a lot to her.
Say, does Lily still have that house down by the track?
Lily? Why, sure she does. Does good business.
You go down there?
Me? No, never.
Well, how do you manage?
I manage.
Yeah, well, I hope so, Willie. You know it's important for a man to have an outlet. I think I'll go for a little walk, so to speak.
Good idea. Walk your dinner down.
Yeah. I may stop off someplace, so maybe a little late getting home.
I'll keep the back door open. Have a good... But
thank you kindly, Willie. I plan to.
Time.
There he is. That's my daddy. Isn't he handsome?
Oh, Bailey, we sure could use a few more like you here in Stamps.
Oh, yeah? No, no. Couldn't stay here in Stamps. You got too many chickens in the road. Mm-mm. Maybe it's not for me. It ain't for you either. Why don't you get away from Stamps?
You want to take me back to California with you,
baby? No, I couldn't do that. I'm taking my kids with me when I go. They're getting big now. I don't want my boy growing up to be no cotton picker.
Were you coming back to see me, Bailey? I sure like seeing you again, like old times.
Yeah, like old times. Mm. Yeah, we sure did used to have some great times, didn't we? Yeah, Lily, you know, I think I am gonna come back and see you. Right after supper, you gonna be available for me?
I'm always available for you, baby.
Mm-hmm. Mm.
What about your mother? Won't she be mad about this?
My mother and father are divorced, so it's okay, I guess.
Your dad is taking you to California? You didn't tell me that, Maya.
I don't have to tell you everything, Julie. I mean, some things is family business.
Mama, I don't want to go to California with Daddy. I want to stay here with you. I could take over Bella's chores as well as my own.
Put this on, sister. Let me see the fit.
You want me to go, Mom? You want me to leave you?
Put on the jumper.
You want me to go away, maybe never see you again?
Big Bailey is your daddy. You belong with your daddy.
Put it on. It's a good fit. Just have to fix the hem.
Mama.
Won't you look in? Nice and neat when you see relations. Be a good girl now you're here. Don't you make folks think I didn't raise you right.
Say goodbye to anyone? Huh? Huh? Am I?
Well, you take care of everything here, okay?
I will, Billy. I will.
Take care of this sweet thing right here.
Be a good girl now. He'll always love you.
Not too tight. Yeah. That's good. Now, keep that left fender right there, just on the right side of that white line in the middle of the road. You're doing real fine. Real fine. Hey, you like the way your brother's driving, Marguerite?
It's making me car sick.
Well, you want to come sit up here with us and steer?
No, thank you.
Daddy?
Yeah?
Will you teach me to drive all by myself?
Sure will, son. Hey, every man's got to learn how to drive a big car. That's where you get the ladies to loving you. You got any ladies loving you, son?
Yeah, a few.
Hey, is that right, Marguerite?
If he says so.
Hey, if you're anything like me, son, you're going to have lots of ladies flocking around you. I mean, it's the chemistry. Something they smell about us, let us know we're going to treat them real good. Hey, watch it. All right.
Marguerite. Marguerite, wake up, baby. We're here. Wake up.
This is California?
Oh, no, no, baby. We're in St. Louis.
Maya, we're going to see Mother.
Mama? Mama's here?
Not Mama, Mother.
You think your grandmother's here? What'd you think she did? Got up on her roof and flew here?
Oh, my babies! Oh, my babies. Are these my babies?
Yeah, here they are, Vivian. That's your own flesh and blood. Your daughter Marguerite right there and your son Bailey Jr.
Oh, Bailey. Well, 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 Bailey Jr. Well, what do you have to say for yourself?
You my mother?
Yes. Yes, Bailey, I am your mother. But come here, Bailey. Come here. Come here. Let me hug you. Let me hug you.
As I watched Bailey fall in love with our mother, I knew that we would never get to California. We were in St. Louis to stay.
Now, you just move those things off that table, Bailey Jr., while I put this tray right there. Good. Oh, my, my, my. They are beautiful children. Just beautiful. And you know, I think they're going to be tall, Marguerite especially. Yes, I can tell by her hands. Don't you think so, Bailey?
Yeah, well, sure, baby, and they're going to be tall. I'm tall, you're tall. It follows our children to be tall, doesn't it?
Mm-hmm. We'll have to send Bailey to school, turn him into a city boy. Marguerite, I'm going to take you shopping, buy you some smart new clothes. You wear a bra yet?
Vivian, you ain't got no sense. You're embarrassing your daughter.
I did? Well, why? Oh, Marguerite, you're still a farm girl. God, I'm sorry. But don't you worry none. I'm going to slick you up real fine. Now, come on. I want you to eat something. I fixed this for you. Have some hot chocolate with some extra whipped cream.
I think I'll drink a pitcher of that, Mother.
Yes, I know you will. And have some of these. They're lovely, tasty ham sandwiches.
Where's the ham?
Well, here it is, darling.
This is ham? It's so skinny.
Hey, she's used to her grandmother's thick slabs of ham, not that.
No, I'm not. I like this.
So, we have company, I see.
Hello, Mother Baxter. So good to see you. Looking well.
Hello, Bailey. I didn't expect to see you here tonight. Like old times, you and Vivian together. Children, come here. When you were less than 3 years old, Bailey Jr., you taught your sister how to walk. Did you know that?
No, Grandmother Baxter.
But you did. You didn't like the way she stumbled and tumbled about, and you said, "This is my sister. I have to teach her to walk." That's Baxter pride. You hear that, Mr. Parmenian?
Yes, ma'am, Mrs. Baxter. That's a nice family you have. Really a nice family.
Family. That's all that matters. Nothing means a beetle's behind without a family to share it with. My husband, your grandfather, used to say, "I live for my wife, my children, and my dog." We'll get to know each other better in the days to come. But right now, me and Mr. Parmenian has got some business to take care of.
I'm most grateful, Mrs. Baxter. I won't forget it.
I didn't do a thing yet, did I, Parmenian?
No, Mrs. Baxter, not yet.
Nothing for you to be grateful for, then, is there?
Well, I'm grateful anyway. I was just too trusting.
And too greedy.
And too greedy? You're absolutely right. Mrs. Baxter, understand.
Is your mother still fixing tickets?
Oh, that's not a ticket, Bailey. He runs a two-bit gambling operation. He just got himself busted. You see, children, your grandmother is precinct captain of this district. She's a very important person. And you are very important children.
Hard to tell. She's mostly under the covers. That's it, you talk, girl.
Why are you in my room?
Yeah. Talks real nice.
Good, strong voice, just like a mother.
Who are you?
Why, we's your uncles. This your Uncle Tommy, I'm Ira, and he's your Uncle Tootie. He's the youngest and the biggest.
And the meanest.
No, you ain't Tootie. I'm the meanest.
He the meanest, all right.
And your mother Vivian is meaner than all of us put together. But we all mean, Marguerite. You never has to worry about nothing. Nothing ever gonna happen to you.
You really my uncles?
Blood uncles.
I'm gonna tell you apart.
That's easy. Just remember, Tootie's in suspenders, Tom has on a blue shirt, and I got a tan shirt. You got that?
Wow! Well, I think we can get everything in there. You sure got a big trunk.
Yeah. I bet it wouldn't be big enough if we had to put all of Marguerite's books in here. Marguerite? I like for you to read, baby. But too much reading ain't good either.
I like to read.
Yeah, well, do you like to do anything else? Do you like to fish, sing, dance, anything?
I guess so.
Well, you certainly do a lot of guessing. Whew. Well, man, I guess I'll be seeing you again soon.
I'll miss you, Daddy. Now that I know you, I'll miss you a lot.
I'll tell you what. You just keep on eating and trying to grow, okay? You know, it beats me how you're small and your sister keeps getting bigger. Hey, Marguerite?
Well, do you guess you'd like to walk me to the car? And do you guess you'd like to ride me sometime?
I don't have your address.
Well, you can ride me at the La Siena Hotel on Clifford Street in San Francisco, okay?
Is that where you live?
Oh, no. That's where I work. Is that where I live? Well, that's a good one. And, Bailey Jr., you keep an eye on your sister here. Y'all are close, and I like that. And, Marguerite, sure hope you find out what it is you like and what it is you don't like.
I know what I like. I like Mama. I like Bailey. And I like the store. I don't like being here in St. Louis. I don't like people looking me up and down and saying they should be proud of me a lot. I don't like people laughing at me. And most of all, I don't like talking to you.
Hi. How do you do?
How do you do?
Oh, pretty good, thank you. You must be Vivian's girl. My name's Freeman. I'm a friend of your mother's.
Oh?
Your daddy leave?
Yes, he did. Just now.
You sorry to see him go?
No.
You know, I never liked my daddy neither.
My mother's not home.
No, your mother's not home. Your mother's hardly ever home. She's a very busy woman. Very, very busy. And me, I'm not so busy. So I wait for her. And you know something? I spend a lot of time waiting.
What do you do? I mean, while you're waiting, what do you do?
Oh, I play games.
What kind?
The kind you don't need nobody to play with. Like, tic-tac-toe, solitaire.
You play checkers?
Yeah, I play checkers. And mind you, I'm very good. You got a set? Okay, I'll bring one the next time. Okay, I got something. Come here. Put your hand in mine. Okay. See? It's like patty cake, only more fun. You see, the point of this game is for you to get your hand out of mine before I can slap it, like this. Oh, you learn fast. All right, now, it's your turn. Ow! Nice, nice.
John, may I have a white turkey and for my children, boiled shrimp and cola? You do like that, don't you, children? Do you see that room back there, the big room? That's a gambling room. That's where I work. I'm a dealer for card games. You know, Reedy, it's very important for you to work, darling. That way you have your independence. The minute a man knows you're dependent upon him, well, that's the minute he kicks you right in the head.
Boo, what you got there?
Robbing the cradle, honey.
Well, don't you know these are my children?
How you doing, lovey? You as good a dancer as your mom?
No, we don't dance.
Don't dance? You came from Vivian and you don't dance? Well, now, that just ain't possible.
Would you like to give it a try?
No.
If you want us to, Mother dear.
About coming home.
Why should I come home? And you're supposed to be working anyway.
I finished work. I want you to come home.
Oh, you do, do you? Who the hell do you think you are anyway? Telling me where to go, when to come home, who to spend my time with? I don't belong to you, Freeman.
Who do you belong to then? Someone else?
I belong to Vivian Baxter, and you best remember that. And I don't much like you tracking me down and embarrassing me.
I'm going, Viv. You coming with me?
Oh, Freeman, you don't have to go. Why can't you just stay for a little while and have a few drinks, and then we can all go home together?
I'm leaving now. I want you to come with me.
I'll see you later. John, another white turkey, please. And then why can't we all just have a good time?
We can read to each other. We haven't done that in a long time, Belle.
Yeah, maybe tomorrow or tonight.
Who cares? Who cares anyway?
Hello.
Good morning, little sister.
Is Mommy home?
No.
No. No, 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 no.
But she just went downtown shopping. She left her lunch on the stove and said you should wait for her.
Yeah. Okay. I'm waiting. Where is that Bailey Jr.?
Outside, playing.
Oh, we play nice, don't we? You and me. You like to play games with me, don't you? I can tell.
Are you okay, Mr. Freeman?
Am I okay? Sure, of course I'm okay. Why you ask anyway?
You act funny.
Hey, wanna play? Come on, come on, come on. Come on, put him there. Come on, come on. I'm gonna do it now. Okay, put him there.
You're not very fast today, Mr. Freeman.
All right, okay. Again. Again. Okay, one more. One more. One more.
What are you doing, Mr. Freeman? That's not fair.
You like me, don't you, Reedy? You and me, we are friends, ain't we?
Yeah, sure. But I don't like this game.
Yeah, it's okay. You're gonna like it.
No, I don't like it.
Yeah. Yeah.
Please, let me go.
If you scream, Meyer, I'm going to have to kill Bailey. Hear me? If you make any noise, and if you tell anybody, I'm gonna have to kill Bailey. Hear me? If you tell anybody, I'm going to kill Bailey.
What are you doing, Mr. Freeman? What are you doing? Let him go! Let him go! Let him go! Marguerite? Marguerite? Baby? Baby, are you sick? Huh? Darling, tell Mother. What happened?
Mother, I'm hurt. How are you feeling? Mother dear said I should let you sleep. But I'd rather be here with you. Is that okay, Ma? You want me to be here with you or you want me to go away? I want you to stay here with me. Ma, you gotta tell me who did this to you. You gotta tell, Maya. You gotta tell who did this to you. Or the man who hurt another little girl. I won't leave till you tell. I can't. Why can't you? If I tell, he'll kill you. Me? He can't kill me. I won't let him. Did I ever lie to you, Maya? Huh? Answer me that.
Did I ever lie to you? Hey, you know I don't lie to you. He won't kill me. Uh-uh. No, no, he won't. He won't kill me.
It was Mr. Freeman.
Bailey.
Shh. First thing the judge said was, you're better off in jail than out on the streets where decent people can get at you. But he still suspended the sentence. The hearing didn't even last 15 minutes. I knew they shouldn't have let Freeman out, not in this neighborhood. He was a sitting duck. He was just found on a lot behind the slaughterhouse.
Yes, hurt bad?
He's dead.
Poor Freeman, do they know who did it?
They think it was more than one. Some say he was kicked to death.
Well, Phil, thanks for telling me. Poor man, poor Freeman. Well, you know, maybe it's better this way. He was a mad dog. Would you like some lemonade or beer?
No, thanks, ma'am. I'd best be getting on. Just wanted to let you know.
Well, glad you did, then. Give my best to you all. Thank you, Phil. Maya and Junior, you didn't hear a thing, understand? I never want to hear about this situation again. And I never want to hear that evil man's name in this house again, do you understand? Sit down at the table with your uncles, and I'll give you some apple strudel.
Dead because of me, because I had spoken, because of words that had passed my lips, a human being was gone from this world. I decided then and there that no words would pass my lips again.
You'll have to read your composition out loud, Marguerite. Otherwise, I'll have to give you a failing grade.
I'm so glad you could come. I'm having a party, and you and Bailey Jr. are my honored and my only guests. Now, Bailey, sir, if you would be so kind as to please crank up that Victrola, perhaps we can have some music. Come on, baby.
Can I have a brownie, Mother dear?
You absolutely can. And so can your sister. I'm probably the best party giver in St. Louis. I'll tell you the secret of giving a party. It's GF. It's good friends and good food and good fun. Come on, Bailey. Dance with Mother dear. Come on.
Okay.
Let's try the snake hips, remember?
Bum, bum.
let you go. Johnny, would you like to have another brownie?
Here.
How did you leave heaven? I'd like to know. Why did you trade heaven for all these earthly things? Where did you leave your halo and where did you leave your wings? Haven't they missed you? And can you get back in? If I kissed you, would it be a sin? I am only human, but you are so divine. When did you leave heaven, angel mine?
That was good, Mother dear. You sounded like a real singer.
Sure I did. Bailey, you know I can do anything. I can sing, I can dance, I can deal cards. I can even get little girls to talk. Talk, Maya. Come on and talk. Darling, please talk. Talk for your mother. Let me hear you talk. Let me hear those big words that hardly fit into your mouth. Talk for me, baby. Come on, please. Maya, please. Please.
What's wrong with you, Maya? What are you doing this for?
Come here, baby. Maya, there's nothing wrong with you. There ain't a thing wrong with you. The doctor says you can talk as good as anyone. You know, lots of folks say that you're just being willful. That you just need a good thrashing and that you'll be okay. Baby, you know I don't go for that stuff. Ain't nobody gonna hit my babies. Not even me. But I wanna give you a party and make brownies and show you a good time. Maya. I don't know. I don't know how to take care of you anymore, Maya. Maya. Do you know what I mean?
Once again, our mother was unable to cope with us. And once again, we were on the train heading back to Arkansas. Leaving Mother had broken Bailey's heart. But for me, the barrenness of stamps was exactly what I wanted.
To you about what happened? She tell you Maya stopped talking?
Good Lord can hear her good enough. I'll fix us a nice breakfast.
You'd like that, won't you, Bailey Jr.?
Sure do, Mama.
And how about you, sister?
What's it like up there? Got real high buildings, I hear. That right, sister?
Lots of cars and trucks.
Don't wait for you to cross the street. Liable to hit you. Run you down if you ain't careful.
Well, what else did you see in St. Louis, child? You got something to tell us? Child?
Buildings are so high in St. Louis that in the winter you can't see the top floors.
Ever ride on one of them elevators?
White folks at a different, like they say.
The snow is so deep in St. Louis,
You can get buried right outside your front door, and people won't find you for a year. Everybody wears new clothes, and everybody has inside toilets. And if you fall down in one of them, you get flushed away into the Mississippi River.
Simple. Just simple. Poor thing.
Ain't nothing wrong with my grandbaby. She'll talk soon enough. Soon as she gets her mind to say something.
Get me when I call.
Me before the dancing starts. That's different. It makes Kitty all the boys smell fishy, too. Did you ever let a boy touch you?
Not me. Did you?
Tommy Badon wanted to. So did Sam Needham. He said the girls do it.
Do you know Lorraine? She goes all the way.
How do you know?
Maya told me. That's what she Maya.
You ever let a boy touch you, Maya?
Why do you ask Pa all those questions?
She can't talk. She can just shake her head yes or no. Get you, Maya?
Don't run away, Maya. You gotta do the fish. Get out, wrap them up.
Hi, Marguerite. I didn't mean to startle you.
Oh, thank you.
Actually, you startled me. I didn't know anyone was here. I was going down to put my feet in the water. Want to come with me? This book is called A Tale of Two Cities by Charles Dickens. It was the best of times. It was the worst of times. It was the age of wisdom. It was the age of foolishness. It was the epoch of belief. It was the epoch of incredulity. Would you like to read some more? Take good care of it. I won't accept any excuse if you return a book to me that has been badly handled. I will lend you others too. But you must do one thing in return. I want you to choose a section and read it aloud. The words are so beautiful on the page, but they're much more beautiful when spoken aloud. Marguerite, no one is going to make you talk. Possibly no one can. But if you love words, and I think you do, you won't want to miss the joy of hearing them spoken in your own voice. Your own voice.
was the best of times. It was the worst of times. It was the age of wisdom. It was the age of foolishness. It was the epoch of belief. It was the epoch of incredulity. It was the season of light. It was the season of darkness. It was the spring of hope. It was the winter of despair. We had everything before us. We had nothing before us.
All right, quiet, class. Our principal has an announcement to make to us.
Thank you, Miss Flowers. I am dressing the classes individually this morning instead of announcing the contents of this letter at a general assembly. You are familiar with the Negro National Anthem, or what is known to us as the Negro National Anthem. We here at Lafayette County Training School, as well as other Negro schools, have been accustomed to singing this poem at assemblies. Well, now, we won't be doing this anymore. You see, the local Board of Education advises us that the poem, Lift Every Voice and Sing, is not a official anthem, and therefore should not be sung along with the Star Spangled Banner and the Pledge of Allegiance and the Benediction, of course. So, naturally, we shall abide by this edict. Thank you.
The contender, Joe Louis, moving into the center of the ring. He's taken the fight to Brenner, and there, a great right to the head and a left hook to the body by Louis. And now the champion, raining blows on Louis. He's got Louis against the ropes with a left to the body and a right to the ribs. Another right to the body. It looks like it was low. Referee says no, no. Ladies and gentlemen, this is really the fight of the century. The referee moving in to break him up, but there's still
that white man don't mind hugging that nigga now.
Bringing on, but now he's backing away. Now he's moving towards the center of the ring. And it looks like Joe Louis is really mad now. He's caught Brenner with a left hook to the head and a right to the body. Another left jab to the body. Another left to the head. There's a left hook and a right hook to the head. Joe is mad. He's caught Brenner with a left hook to the head and a right to the body. A left jab to the body and another good left hook to the head. Louis sends a left to the body and a right cross to the chin. There's a left hook, a right to the head. The champion's right eye is bleeding and the champion, Brannock, is down. He's on the canvas, ladies and gentlemen. Two, three, four, five, six, seven. The champ trying to get up. Nine, ten. He's out.
Where you headed, Tom?
Oh, I thought about where the school be best.
We'll go that way too then. Got my rifle in the wagon.
Yeah.
Oh, Lord Jesus, I pray we don't have no trouble tonight.
Anyone wants is welcome to stay here. We put mats and quilts on the floor. Best be on the safe side.
Yep. Wouldn't do for a black man and his family to be on a lone road tonight. On the night when Joe Louis proved he's the greatest people on the world.
Oh, come on, let's go home. See about them children.
Uncle Willie?
are you okay?
Just fine. Just fine. Some fight, huh? A good fight, wasn't it?
Yeah, sure was. Uncle Willie?
He just makes me... You see, sister? He just makes me so glad to be what I am. Makes me feel proud. Proud that we're both black. You see that?
Something. I have to tell you, I never really believed I lived to see this day. And I still can't believe it. I'm 13 and it's graduation day.
Start believing it. They'll be over soon.
Maya, here's your graduation present. I hope you like it. You better like it. I saved for 3 months to buy it. Poems by Edgar Allan Poe. Thank you. I never had a book like this before.
It was many and many a year ago in the kingdom by the sea that a maiden that lived, you may know, by the name of Annabel Lee.
Sister, you taste this yet?
Oh, Mama, I just don't think I can eat anymore.
Maybe if you just take a little peek, it might perk up your appetite.
Oh, Mama! I'm making mouse wash. Oh, Mama! Oh, Uncle Willie, thank you.
I'd like to ask Reverend Davis to lead us in a prayer.
Our heads in prayer. Our Father God, we thank thee for our assembly here for this graduation. We thank thee for the parents of these children.
We look real nice.
For
me?
This remarkable beginning for a more fruitful
so
life
do you.
And be more productive citizen. Amen.
We are departing a bit from our prepared program because our guest speaker today, who is also our friend, came from Texarkana to deliver the commencement address. But due to the irregularity of the train schedule, he is going to, as they say, speak and run. And without further ado, I'd like to introduce you to Mr. Edward Dunleavy.
Good morning. I'm glad to be here and see the things going on here at this school just as they are at the other schools. As some of you may know, and I hope all of you will know, I am running for elective office in this county. One of my platforms is to improve the education of our children, white and Negro. I believe we're giving our Negro children a first-class education for those who want to take advantage of it. Now, if you look out that window, you see weeds and you see all the bushes. But I'm proud to stand here in front of you today and to tell you that before long, soon, when you look out that window, you're going to see not a whole lot of weeds and bushes, but you're going to see a paved playing field. Now, you know what that means, don't you? That means that our boys at Lafayette are going to have a chance to have a full-fledged development of their athletics. Now, we can't forget that Paul Triscoll, one of the first-line football tackles at Arkansas Agricultural and Mechanical College, came from right here at Lafayette. And now for the girls. We're not forgetting you. Now, I can't give you exact dates, but I'm pretty sure that you're bound to get some new equipment for your home economics building. There's no reason why you're not the best cooks and housekeepers in the whole country. Now, these improvements are due, in no small way, to my efforts to improve the educational facilities of Stamps. And I want to tell you that I didn't forget Lafayette County Training School.
I thank you all very much.
Thank you.
Our valedictorian, Marguerite Johnson.
Mr. Principal, dear teachers, fellow graduates, dear parents and friends, our speaker just told us that he was improving the education facilities in Stamps. He's given us a chance to become basketball players and cooks. Well, I want to thank Mr. Dunleavy for this chance, but I don't think I'm going to take it. I didn't memorize the whole of The Rape of Lucrece so I could be a cook or a cleaning lady. See, I give Mr. Dunleavy all the rights he wants, but I don't believe he has the right to decide that my only hero has got to be a first-line football tackle. I got other heroes. For example, Edgar Allan Poe, because I liked what he said, and I liked the way he said it. My teachers, because they showed me a map, and on that map, I saw that the world went past Stamps, Arkansas, United States of America, North America continent. And I got another hero, me. And me is not just a proud member of the graduating class of the Lafayette County Training School. Me is a proud member of the Negro race, the wonderful, beautiful Negro race. Well, I want to thank Mr. Dunleavy for the paved playing field, but I'm not going to run on it. I got other things to do. And I want to thank my grandmother, who taught me how to sing. She said that in order to lift your voice, you have to lift your head. And when you lift your head, you're looking at heaven. So I want to ask my fellow graduates to sing with me the Negro National Anthem. Lift every voice and sing.
What is she doing? That song is not allowed.
It's too late now.
Ring with the harmonies.
Decatur, Alabama, 1931. It started with a freight train rumble.
What happened on that train, girl?
A few hastily spoken words.
Twins both raped. By then.
That launched one of the most embittered court battles the South had ever seen.
Then one of them said, "Girl, I'm gonna give you a black baby."
Eight black men on trial for their lives. Judged by an all-white jury, victims of the Deep South's own brand of justice.
I was framed in Scottsboro.
With Dallas's Ken Kercheval.
Alabama justice cannot be bought and sold with Jew money from New York.
Arthur Hill stars as the courageous judge whose compassion cost him his career. Judge Horton and the Scottsboro Boys.
If you believe that this is a state and a country where every man is a king, but no man wears a crown, then I want you to vote for Huey Long for the United States.
Louisiana, 1932, a time of bread lines and soup kitchens, when people reached out for hope in the name of Huey Long. He established his reputation as a defender of the poor and spokesman against big business.
Why weep or slumber, America? Land of brave and free, with palaces and clothing and food for all. All belongs to you.
The South had never seen the likes of one such colorful politician.
Never write what you can phone. Never phone what you can talk head and head. Never talk what you can nod. Never nod what you can wink. Never wink what you can look. That's rule number two.
What's number one?
Never question the kingfish.
His aspirations led to the White House, but an assassin's bullet ended that dream.
Oh, Roosevelt thinks I'm one of the two most dangerous men in the country. The other being Douglas MacArthur. I resent the company more than the allegation.
Huey.
Yeah.
Hi.
Edward Asner stars as the late United States Senator Huey Long in The Life and Assassination of the Kingfish. He was a naive young priest who came to the island of Molokai, a small leper colony, with hopes of becoming the spiritual leader.
This church is now open for prayer. Those who wish to confess
now have a priest who will listen.
He faced natural obstacles in a poor community where disease was the only common denominator.
You think you can cleanse the leprous soul? Others have tried and failed. This place is a sewer.
He developed a special rapport with his people.
Don't be afraid. Come, give me your hand. Then you did play once.
Yes.
Would you like to play again?
How?
Just as you always did. No one will miss the notes you don't hit.
I will.
And fought a religious bureaucracy where Catholics and Protestants were bitter enemies.
Some doctor told the members of the board that leprosy is an advanced form of syphilis. As a result, they tend to believe that lepers are suffering the effects of their own behavior and therefore deserve God's punishment.
That is not God's punishment, nor is it Catholic punishment.
The board is Protestant, Father.
He then met his greatest challenge when he became afflicted with a disease.
Our Lord has willed that I be one of you. I am a leper.
Mike Farrell and Ken Howard star.
I must go back. I will go back.
Father Damien.
I won't be still. I'm sick of your accusations. I have kept my faith. I have led others to that faith. I will not stand here.
Father Damien.
In a sensitive drama based on the life of Father Damien de Buster. Damien, the leper priest. Betty Davis is the lonely widow who takes a street-tough teenager into her home.
Put your feet on the floor.
She gave him his first lessons in love and human respect.
Big deal.
He opened her eyes to the harsh realities of life. Realities that were soon to become her own.
An eviction notice.
And when the chips were down...
You're sick, don't you see that?
The kid returned her kindness.
I'm gonna take care of her.
They had nothing in common but a will to survive.
You saved my life.
And no one to save but each other. A tale of a truly unlikely team. But what a team they made. Betty Davis stars with Ernest Hardin Jr. in White Mama. It was the mid-1920s when the appearance of a woman flashed across the consciousness of millions, successfully competing for headlines with bootleggers, flagpole sitters, sports figures, and the glittering personalities of Hollywood's silent era. She inspired the most impassioned belief and became known worldwide as Sister Amy.
I was blindfolded and taken outside. They threw me into the back of an auto, bound and gagged, and we began to drive. They put a blanket over me so I couldn't see where we were going. I heard another machine. Finally, the auto stopped. They took me into an old adobe shack, dirty, with one poor room. 2 days later, Steve came back and demanded again that I write a letter to you. When I refused, they cut off two locks of hair from my head. And if that doesn't convince her, we'll cut off your finger and we'll send that to her.
In 1926, evangelist Amy Semple McPherson mysteriously disappeared from the beach in Venice, California. Her claim to have been kidnapped left police officials skeptical and suspicious.
There have been persistent rumors about your relationship with Kenneth Ormiston. Witnesses claim that they saw you with him in Salinas, in San Luis Obispo, riding with him in a blue Chrysler coupe near Santa Barbara. Now, all this, supposedly, during the time you were missing.
Mr. Ryan, since I was bound hand and foot in a Mexican desert, I obviously wasn't joyriding with Mr. Ormiston in Santa Barbara or anywhere else.
While others had doubts, her congregation remained loyal. Betty Davis.
Were you with Ormiston? Answer me! Were you with Ormiston?
And Faye Dunaway star
They're setting you up, Amy, to pull you down.
Well, let them try. Let them. My people will believe me. I'll win.
A fascinating true story of religion, suspense, and love. The disappearance of Amy.